Welcome to Health Professional Radio. I'm your host, Neal Howard, on this Health Suppliers segment. Our guest is Dr. Jay Yepuri. He's Chief Medical Officer for NutriForward, joining us today to discuss their product, RiduZone. Welcome to the program, Jay. How are you?
I'm well. Thank you for having me.
A bit of a background about yourself, Duff. What do you do and where do you do it for NutriForward?
Sure. So I, as you mentioned in the introduction, I'm Chief Medical Officer for NutriForward. We are a science-based nutraceutical company in the based in the Dallas-Fort Worth area. I'm also my other hat, if you will, is I'm a gastroenterologist or specialist in digestive and liver diseases, and I'm in active clinical practice here in the Dallas-Fort Worth area as well.
How long have you been with NutriForward?
NutriForward came together in 2014,
okay.
So we're a little under 4 years old at
okay,
this point.
Great. We're here to talk about RiduZone. What is RiduZone and how can folks benefit from it?
So RiduZone's active ingredient is a molecule called OEA, which stands for something called oleoylethanolamide. OEA is a metabolite of oleic acid, which is a breakdown product of fat. And why I mention that is we all make OEA within our own bodies in the small intestine, which is the site of most nutrition absorption. But we don't make enough for it to have some of its beneficial effects that we see when we supplement OEA with RiduZone. And those are particularly strong effects or beneficial effects in terms of craving appetite. So curbing cravings, as well as burning fat and increasing metabolism. So we're able to make people feel full when they take OEA or RiduZone, which again is primary ingredient is OEA, and they also are able to burn fat and increase their metabolism and control weight in that regard.
So it uses OEA. Now, this is in order to lose weight or maintain a healthy metabolism or a combination of the two. Can it be used for either or?
Well, so we're very careful to talk about and to really focus on using RiduZone, which contains OEA, as part of a balanced diet and a healthy exercise regimen in order to achieve, an individual's goals as far as weight and appetite control. So, we really believe firmly that it's best used in that context in terms of overall good health.
Does it target specific cravings, as you said, say for carbs or sugar or something else, or is it overall hunger that it curbs?
That's a very good question. And what it really craves is overall hunger. So the best way to describe it is that it just makes you feel full. One pathway that OEA works via is a receptor or a molecule in the lining of the gut of the intestine that once the OEA binds that receptor, causes a signal to a major nerve called the vagus, V-A-G-U-S nerve, that transmits directly to the satiety or the center of the brain that says, hey, I feel full. So it's that nerve impulse transmission to that center of the brain that triggers that I feel full sensation. To answer your question, that's across any type of nutrient, be it carbs, proteins, fat, or anything. The idea, though, is it doesn't make you not want to eat completely. It just because you feel full, you will, as a result, tend to eat more appropriate portion sizes and really kind of think more carefully about what you're eating.
Is this something that should be taken with every meal, twice a day, once a day? How is it to be administered for the maximum benefit?
It depends on the individual. We initially have people start it twice a day before meals, and then for some folks, they may benefit to increasing to three times a day, depending on their response to the initial trial of twice or the initial twice a day. We usually have people take it 3 months, and then we have them take a month or so off before starting it back again.
Now, this is FDA accepted. Were there any hurdles that were above and beyond what you would normally expect to being FDA approved?
That's an excellent question. So we are very proud of the fact that we have an NDI or New Dietary Ingredient Acknowledgement from the FDA. Based on the rigorous safety profile of RiduZone, we completed the first human safety trial that showed complete safety, really no significant adverse effects from RiduZone in humans. And because of that, we were able to achieve that new dietary ingredient acknowledgement from the FDA. And as you're probably aware, for supplements to meet that standard, is a bit of a rare thing. Only one in five really are successful at the first go-around of achieving that acknowledgement. So we did it the first go-around. The science behind OEA and the safety behind OEA is really imputable.
Is this something that a person can just jump right into, or do you suggest having a complete understanding about your particular metabolism and your health before you start to take the supplement?
That's an excellent question. I think it depends on the individual person. If there are certain health conditions that they're trying to get under control, say diabetes, high cholesterol, hypertension, or other conditions, medical diagnoses that they are treating and hoping to modify based on a diet exercise regimen and then wanting to incorporate OEA into that regimen, I think that's appropriate to do that under the care or guidance of a healthcare professional, a trainer, or both. Again, the science and the safety behind OEA and RiduZone is so rigorous that really taking it in the context, even someone just trying to live a healthier lifestyle and achieve those goals on their own, you know, I think they're fine to do that on their own, just with what we've shown and what we have available to us as far as the science and safety go.
What availability are we talking about? Recently approved by the FDA, is this readily available nationwide, or is this something that some of us may have to wait on for several months or maybe even a year or more?
RiduZone is available for sale as we speak. If you'd like more information on RiduZone, the site is very simple. It's RiduZone, RiduZone.com. And there's information on the site as far as more of the science, as well as how to purchase RiduZone, instructions on its use, and how best to incorporate it into a healthy lifestyle.
Well, I appreciate you coming in, Dr. Yepuri, hoping that you'll come back in and give us some updates as RiduZone gets more and more exposure.
It's my pleasure, and happy to do so at any time.
You've been listening to Health Professional Radio. I'm your host, Neal Howard. Transcripts and audio of this program are available at healthprofessionalradio.com.au and also at hpr.fm. You can subscribe to this podcast on iTunes, listen in, and download at SoundCloud. And be sure and visit our affiliates page at hpr.fm.